Good morning, Farmington. I'm Max Mayleben.
And I'm Hailey Person.
We have a beautiful day out. Great show today. I'm actually wearing Birkenstocks today. That's how happy I am.
It's going to be a good day. So we have some more life hacks this week. We have a couple special guests from City Hall. And we have a live audience today. So that's really exciting.
And lots more.
Wake up, Farmington.
A live presentation from Advanced Live Television and Radio. It's Wake Up Farmington. And now, here's your hosts, Hailey Person and Max Mayleben.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We have a special show today because we have a special live audience
we
out
do.
Here with the Bachman and Dodge
Middle
students,
School,
which is
yeah.
really exciting.
Super exciting. Did you know that today is Cinco de Mayo?
Cinco de Mayo. I knew that. Actually, I was a little more excited yesterday because yesterday was May the 4th. Kind of more my forte.
Oh, you know? Star Wars. Gotcha. May
yep.
the 4th be with you.
Exactly.
Yes. I know Star Wars, kind of. I've
no,
never seen.
She doesn't.
I've never seen any of the movies.
No. Oh, okay. You're fired.
Okay. Great.
It's also your sister's birthday, correct?
It is, yeah.
How old is she?
Seven?
Well, you had to think
Eight?
About that for a while.
Well, she's...
okay.
I'm not good with birthdays.
I totally am the same way. We actually have the radio station. They're doing another call-in segment, which is going to be really fun. So stay tuned, and you can win a fun prize. When we come back, we'll have some members from the... Farmington
City
Hall.
Yep.
We'll have them joining us in the studio for an interview. So let's shoot it over to the radio.
Hi, welcome to the radio station. I'm Emma.
I'm Lydia.
I'm Tyler.
And today for you, we have some special guests and some riddles.
Hello, I am Dane, your kind of second local Lakeville Farmington bass player.
Hello, I am Preston.
And I am Billy.
So today for you, we have some trivia.
We have a couple more questions this week, and I'll be asking them. The extension number should be on your screen, so you can call in if you know the answer. But please don't call in until I'm finished telling
you the
questions.
We cannot express that enough. Please do not call in early.
Okay, ready? Scientists have proven that one side of the... Thanks, Emma.
Yep.
Scientists have proven that one side of the cat has more fur than the other. Which side would that be?
Intrigue is killing me.
Do you have an answer for us?
No.
Oh, okay.
Thanks.
Great.
Hi, do you guys have an answer for us? Next caller.
I guess that's a no.
You have an answer for us?
Yes, the right side.
Incorrect. Do you have an answer for us?
Thanks.
Do you have an answer for us?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
It's the outside. The
yeah.
outside.
Hey.
That is correct.
That's correct.
Good job, sir.
It's the outside of the cat.
Yeah, boy.
All right,
what
guys.
What class are we calling from today?
Miss Braylon's class.
Nice job, Miss Braylon's class.
This
Congratulations.
Awesome. Good for you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
All right. Riddle number two. Try not to call if you don't have an answer. Okay. You can see me in water, but I never get wet. What am I?
Hi, do you have an answer for us?
What's the answer?
Giraffe.
That is incorrect. I'm sorry.
Do you have an answer for us today?
Hello?
Hi.
Say hello.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
Do you have
hello.
An answer?
next caller.
Sorry.
Do you have an answer for us today?
Is it air bubbles?
Incorrect.
Do you have an answer for us?
Yes.
What is it?
Reflection.
Yep.
Good job. Whose class is calling?
This is Zach O'Brien with Mr. Anderson's class.
Congratulations.
Listen, thanks for calling in.
Awesome. All right, so we got two right answers now. I think we're almost out of time, so we're going to sign off now, yeah?
Yep.
All right, we will send it back to you guys at the desk. Okay, we're done now.
We're done.
We can't stress that enough. We're done. We're going to send it back to you guys at the desk.
Ah, that was fun. So we have Mike Slavik, right?
That's right. Yeah.
Jay Cordes and Mayor Todd Larson here with us today. How are you guys this morning?
Doing good.
We're doing good.
We're doing great.
So could we go through really quick? We had a question.
Before we get started.
Yes.
Has anyone seen Brooke Larson? Is she here today?
I believe she's running camera two right today. She actually showed up to class.
Yeah.
She didn't drive with you?
Yeah.
No, she didn't. Matter of fact, she wasn't even awake when I left.
Oh, no.
Well, sounds like
she's here now.
Okay.
So
if we could, let's go through and just say what you do at the City Hall, and then like what your role is, and then what you do with that role.
Well, I'm actually on the county board, so I'm out of Hastings, the county board. We're a 7-person board. We go in and go and do everything that the City Hall does, plus so much more. We've got parks, roads, libraries, but we also do
jails.
All the jails. Yeah, we do all the stuff like that. So,
awesome.
Great. And I'm Jay Cordes, as you mentioned. I'm the chair of the Farmington School Board. We meet at City Hall, but we're actually officed out of the high school here.
Why do you guys meet at City Hall now?
Because you guys have great audio and visual equipment there that we like to use.
And you guys needed new stuff, and we said, don't spend money on new stuff. Why don't you just meet
exactly.
in our chambers because they're empty anyway. So
yep.
it's the way that the city and the school were partnering.
Awesome.
Good job.
Yep.
That's
awesome.
Cool. And then what as mayor, what are kind of the daily duties?
I don't really have daily duties at all.
Yeah.
No, I have a great staff that handles most everything for me.
Okay.
I show up for meetings and I show up to City Hall when I need to be at City Hall, and I can't thank them enough. But my main duty is to run the meetings and sign papers after the meeting.
Awesome.
What are some changes you guys would like to see to the Farmington community, as well as how it will affect high schoolers and stuff like that?
I'll go there. I would like to see more commercial retail in the city, and what that would do is create jobs for the high school students and other people around the community. So we will start to see that here relatively soon. I'm excited to say. I can't say what everything is right now, but a lot of it is hinging on Hy-Vee's construction schedule. So Hy-Vee's, they bought land in Vermilion River Crossing, which is out by McDonald's, if you don't know where that is. And right now we're just waiting for them to give us a construction schedule.
Gotcha.
That's awesome.
So I'm not a big fan of Hy-Vee because I work at Target. But my one question for you is: there going to be a Starbucks inside of the Hy-Vee?
No.
There's Ooh. Not.
No, there's going to be a Starbucks next to the Hy-Vee gas station along Highway 50.
Oh,
so
okay.
Adjacent too.
That's good enough.
Yeah, just across the parking lot. Yeah.
Awesome. Oh, okay. Okay. Well, then I'm happy. I'm excited.
Well, if you're happy, I'm happy.
She's content. Everybody's
yes,
happy.
Yes, I'm very content.
When Haley's happy, everyone's happy.
That's true.
well, thank you so much for joining us today. We actually are going to throw it over to Cooking With Us. So we're going to throw it over to Cooking With Us. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Cooking With Us. I'm Shay.
And I'm Morgan.
And today we're going to be making protein bites. So we're just going to have 5 ingredients, and it's no baking, so it's really simple. We have 2 cups of peanut butter, a cup of chocolate chips, 3/4 of a cup of flax seeds, and 2 cups of oats. And then we're also going to be adding in 2 tablespoons of honey. Now we're going to put in our oats. The flax seed. Peanut butter.
Ooh.
Okay, we're gonna mix those together, and Morgan, do you wanna help me sprinkle those in as we go? So while we were up here kind of struggling to get the bites onto the parchment paper, Ms. Stencil gave us a pro tip. So she gave us this tool, and then spray it with cooking spray and make sure you pack them in, and then, yep. Easy as that.
Thank you.
Okay, now that we're all done rolling them, let's see how they taste.
This one's falling apart a little bit, but it's, I mean, I already had one, so, but they're really good.
Yeah, they are good. So yeah, this has been our episode this week, Farmington. Thanks for watching.
See you later. I'm Morgan.
I'm Shay.
Thank you, Morgan and Shay. I believe we're going to try some of these granola bars.
Oh. Hey, you guys.
Oh, thank you, Tauchi.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So you can't.
I am deathly allergic, so I'm not going to touch that.
Just
one.
Me. Just are you like okay to be around these?
Yeah,
like,
I'll be fine.
Okay.
If I did eat one, it would be a much more interesting show, though. I think so.
Oh, they're like cold.
Well, yeah, take a bite.
Oh, like crumbly.
How is it?
Kind of tastes like birdseed. But it's, I'm just kidding. Wow. They're really good. They're really good.
Wow.
It's really peanut buttery.
Yeah.
I'm going to put it away so I don't... Do I have to wash my hands now?
No, you're totally fine.
Are you sure?
I will live, yes. Okay. So we actually are going to... We're going to throw it over to Summer with the prom court.
Yes. Summer.
Hi, I'm here with members from the prom court today, and we're going to ask them, like, what their name is, what activities they're involved in, and yeah. Let's start with Jordan.
Hi, I'm Jordan Flaherty. I'm Secretary of Student Council. I do NHS and Youth Teaching Youth.
Hi, I'm Kayla Poissant. I'm in choir and NHS.
I'm Emily Burdan. I'm in softball, volleyball, youth development, and captain's council.
I'm Daniela. I'm a exec board member of NHS, and I'm also a part of the Link crew.
Hi, I'm Amma. I am in track. I'm an NHS diversity club, the in choir, and a wrestling manager.
I'm Drew. I play hockey.
I'm Victoria Holmquist. I am in soccer, and I run track, NHS, and the Brown Bank Junior Board of Directors.
I'm LaRue Cost, and I am a student school board representative.
And then I'm Max Maylaven. I'm in the Tiger. I'm in the Wake Up Farmington crew. I'm in choir, NHS, student council, stuff like that.
All right. Well, if you see someone you like up here, please remember to vote and stuff. Yeah, but we also have some members in our audience today. Cameron, turn around, see all these people. There's some middle schoolers. All right. Well, that's all we have for prom court today. So we're going to send it over to Deep Thoughts with Max and Julian.
Good morning, Farmington. It's Max Maylaven again. We have a special treat this time. We have Julian Rosolco with some special guest star questions.
Hello.
Let's get right into it. This is Deep Thoughts. So we're going outside, Julian, to get the opener.
Anyways, it is 45 degrees, but it feels like 38 for the 2nd of May with a wind of 14 miles an hour at approximately 9.02 a.m. Central.
All right. Can we ask a question really quick? Can you pinpoint one moment of your life that has made you who you are?
I don't know.
All right, moving on. Can you pinpoint one moment of your life that has made you who you are?
I can. I was born.
Where do you see yourself in 15 years?
I see myself like with a family. And I don't know. Wait, just can you redo that?
No,
you
can't redo
no
it.
No redos. Moving on.
Redo that.
No redos.
Excuse me. What does it mean to live a fulfilled life?
Well, that's what you're living, Julian.
I think that's what you're living, Julian.
No comment.
I don't know.
No redos.
Question. Would you die for anything? Probably some cheese balls.
I would die because of cheese balls. Question for you. The fish trap exists because of the fish. Words exist because of meaning. Once you get the meaning, you can forget the words. Have you forgotten the words?
I think so. It's safe to say it.
What does that mean?
You said a lot of things, and I mostly forgot most of it, I think.
That hurts. Let's move on. Look at, they're running, they're running. Oh, they're gone. They're gone. You win this time. Wait. No, come back. Come on, just... Is there a fate?
Maybe.
We got the answer. Let's go. Is there one point in life that you can pinpoint who you are today?
Who I am today?
Yes. What has made you you?
What has made me me? Probably when I was born.
Everybody's saying that. Give me another one.
Oh, geez. Point in my life. Probably when I'll die.
That's new.
Sir. Hey. Got a question. Yeah. Is there fate, or does everyone choose their own path? Why do you prefer that?
I don't know.
Ew.
Well, Julian, I hope this has been an insightful time.
It actually has. Everyone have a nice day.
This has been Deep Thoughts with Max Mayleben, with guest star Julian. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Max.
Thank you.
You know, I could ask another deep question, but I feel like all our minds need a break.
Yes, I agree. All the AP testing has been this week, the MCAs, maybe stressing it. I know I'm stressing about prom.
Yeah, exactly. So I think it's time to just kind of take a moment, take like 30 seconds, just take a breather. So we have some video of Mr. Pickens' fish, and we're just going to take a moment and just chill out.
We're just going to relax. More relaxed.
It's so relaxing.
I feel much better.
with all that relaxation, we're going to throw it to our favorite relaxing part of the show, Julian with the weather. Julian, how you doing?
Good. Hello, people of Farmington. This is Julian Rosoco with the weather. It is currently 55 degrees, but it will be a nice weekend. So without any further ado, today will be high of 75 and a low of 45. And it is sunny throughout most of the week. Saturday, high of 62, low of 41, and sunny. Sunday, high of 66 and a low of 47. Monday, we get back up into the 70s with high of 71 and a low of 56. Tuesday, but it will be cloudy, but still high of 75 and a low of 50. So for my quick news fact, Tesla and Consumer Reports didn't go on very well the past few weeks. So Tesla, Consumer Reports removed the Tesla Model S due to the lack of safety features such as the autopilot and emergency braking That's all. Sending it over to Life Hacks.
Hey, didn't see you there. Welcome back to Life Hacks. I'm Amanda Jacobson.
I'm Bucky Zhang.
Let's do this.
So for this life hack, you'll need a paper towel roll, two plastic cups, and your phone.
Hack, Okay, so for this hack, you're gonna take a plastic cup and cut a little hole in it. You're gonna do the same to the other one. You're gonna cut a hole in a paper towel. All right, and we're gonna put that in there. And then you're gonna put your phone in here. And you can play your favorite song. Mine personally is Jacob Sartorius' Sweatshirt. I love this song. I already have a sweatshirt on. Can I just make this a whole music video? Hack successful. Okay, I'm so done dancing, I need my inhaler.
So for this next life hack, all you'll need is some sort of food and some toothpaste.
So for this life hack, if you don't ever want to brush your teeth in the morning or just running low on time, we're just going to show you something quick and easy that will help you brush your teeth while on the go. We just happen to have a potato, because who doesn't have potatoes right now? And we're just going to like cut it up. Get some Crest toothpaste. Make sure you have the number for poison control ready and near. And we're just...
Now that was it for life hacks. Please don't bully me or me. Now back to you guys at Wake Up Farmington.
I love life hacks. You know what? I'm definitely going to use the speaker thing.
Yeah, it seemed like it really worked.
Did you see the popcorn thing last week?
Mm-hmm.
I did try that.
You did?
My sweatshirt got a little dirty, but it works.
Yeah. That's cool. Mm-hmm. All right, well, that's all we got for this week. I'm Max Mayley.
I'm Haley Person.
I'm Summer Welch.
And I'm Junior Sokol.
Have a great day.